What makes a mission to Russia unique is that we really don't, as Americans, have a true understanding of what Russia is like, and you come here and you find that it's different.
It is my first mission. I'm here because my roots came from here.
It's beautiful, the architecture is great, and the people are great.
I've been on one other ORT mission and it was fantastic. And I thought, wow, to go to Russia with an ORT mission and see where it was born.
The mission to Russia really gives supporters of ORT an opportunity to see firsthand the work that's being done, meet the students, have really a tangible understanding of the good work that ORT is doing in the former Soviet Union.
My favorite subjects are biology, English, Russian, mathematics, and physics.
I think if the book is digital, we can save some natural resources.
Do they learn English as part of the day? Or where do they know their English from?
They start to learn English in the fifth grade.
ORT schools, they weren't really functioning during the Soviet era. It's been a relatively short time, but they've come a very long way.
We have a lot of schools here, but this is one of the best schools in our area. It's a good atmosphere in our school because we have like European and Jewish class. It's one of the highest level of IT technology in our city. I want to be a programmer because you can make something that make people's life better.
ORT использует самые передовые, позволяет использовать учителю самые передовые методы обучения детей, связанные с технологиями. Непосредственно с технологией и непосредственно с технологией обучения.
Seven years ago, we were really advocating for smart classrooms.
And also, it can take something or release something. Can rotate, for example, like a manual screwdriver, yeah.
We all know technology moves very quickly, and what was new and cutting edge is now, yeah, this is a basic thing that you have. What's next?
We have a camera.
You're giving these young people a real opportunity. The job market here is strong for the high-tech industry, and ORT is giving them that chance.
Good, it's good, it's good.
I think we have an elementary school and a junior school here, and you'll see the magic going inside.
Lots of people in this region, because they were disconnected during the Soviet era, they actually have no emotional connection to their roots.
One of the most amazing moments of today was singing Shalom Aleichem with the kids. And even though we speak different languages, we share the same prayers and we share the same tunes and we share the same tradition.
It's really important that they learn their culture, their history, and if they wish to reconnect, to have that opportunity.
The parents check their children, their kids, and the kids check their parents in Hebrew.
Я не скажу, что я учу свою маму ивриту, но я ей рассказываю о том, что у нас было на уроках иврита, потому что ну, это очень интересный язык, история этого языка.
И когда Ольга пошла в школу и, приходя, рассказывает об этом и показывает и буквы, и слова, это настолько интересно, что мы стали ну, тоже интересоваться этим языком.
We've talked about how important what we're doing in the FSU is bringing back Jewish community. Now I really see it. You put a goal together and you try to make it happen, and it happens.
Каждый раз, когда я прихожу из школы домой, первое, что я делаю, это прикасаюсь к мезузе, потому что мезуза — это символ охраны дома, защиты его.
Ну, то, что Илья учится в такой школе, конечно, помогает и нам тоже больше узнавать про нашу историю, про наши корни. И не только ему это полезно, нам тоже. Мы тоже узнаем что-то новое.
We created a real Jewish community again, where there was a Jewish community for generations.
I was thinking about sort of the legend of the phoenix, right, rising from the ashes, and you think about the rebirth and the flourishing of the Jewish community here, which is fantastic.
It taught me how valuable education is and how involved people can be with more than just their own lives.
You realize that for the past 137 years, Ort has been there making a difference, not only in St. Petersburg and in Moscow, but now throughout the world.